Members of the Pride, and welcome back to another episode of Animallica. So as you can see in the background here, we have another mesmer, and we are going to take this bad boy down because it looks like this might be the last actual mesmer on the island. And once we take down this mesmer, I think the only thing that's going to be left are just going to be the what do you call it, the canisters. All right. And since there are canisters here, I don't think it's going to be enough. But that probably means that there's just going to be like a couple of hidden ones here and there, and once we take those down, it'll be we'll be good to go. So, yeah, we're currently at 74. This should take it to 90, right? Yeah. So all we need to do is find. Find one more patch of contaminated containers, and this will be a cleansed area. I kind of figured that we had done an awful lot of searching around before. So I knew we had done at least some of the cleansing before, but I can't remember how much of this. I imagine I'm willing to bet that the other containers are located inside structures. So I'm actually kind of like really tempted. Just like it was like in the barn. I mean, I'll bet you it's stuff like that. So I'm kind of tempted to just run through and just go from structure to structure and just collect what I can. Come on. Oh, the grass in this. The grass thing in this game is just real. It's just so frustrating. It right now it's probably probably my biggest pet peeve of the. Oh my god, it's like for a second it does it and then it just doesn't anymore. It's probably one of my biggest pet peeves in the game, is the fact that it does that, and it's just. It's frustrating, and I really wish that just didn't exist anymore. And eventually it won't. I mean, eventually it will get fixed, and that's why I'm not sitting here ranting and raving about like how broke the game is or anything. You know, the game's in development, to be expected. But should I collect these chickens? Eggs. Should I collect the chickens? Oh, wait. Logs. What logs? Invisible logs. More irises. Don't really care about the irises. Let's see. Don't really care about the plant fiber anyway, but I've got a weaving hut in here, which is always nice, but I don't really need it. Should I just go ahead and collect up these chickens? I kind of wanna. Oh, wait, whoa, hold on. Don't shoot them. Why didn't it switch? Why didn't it keep it on? Oh, it did. Okay. Sorry, buddy. I know. It's no fun being shot with a tranquilizing arrow. Here, chicken. Kind of want to go ahead and just collect these these cows while we're here, too. Boink. May as well use these tranquilizer arrows while I've got them. I mean, this is not a life and death situation. This is an animal collection situation. And since they're extremely docile animals, I should be able to just with the exception of this guy, of course, who is not a docile animal. Gotta remember, the bulls don't do that.
Yeah.
All right. One last chicken? I thought I heard one last chicken around here. I do. I hear one last chicken around here. Where are you? Here, chicken, 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 chicken. Well, it's no big deal. Oh, there you are. All right. And can I go in you?
Yeah.
Can I go in here? I cannot. Huh. All right. So let's go ahead and jump on the horse again, and let's keep on looking for the final bits of contamination. Because once this place is fully cleansed, as far as I know, there really is no other reason to be here. I mean, we can continue to explore the area, but I'm not aware of any special areas that we have not already looked at. Because we have looked at there's like a section over in the ruins area where there's like a little underground area. Is there another one? Well, if there is, then you're gonna have to fend for yourself. I'm sorry. Maybe someday I'll come back and... Was that you? Huh. Oh, there you are! that one. And then... Hey. Sorry, buddy. Oh, and there's another one. You know what? It's fine. Okay, and this is arrows? Yeah, it's more arrows. I don't really have a need for more arrows. Lord knows we have an enormous number of them. Let's get straw, 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 straw. This does not appear to be anything. What? Oh, that's a horse. I was gonna say, what is over there? But it's a horse. Of course, of course. All right, let's continue heading over, and I guess the whole like systematic looking around is kind of just been thrown out the window. Because I guess I'm just sort of like looking around at whatever I see. Oh, well, you know, systematic gets, like, old after a while. Sometimes you just gotta ramble. You know what they say? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I see sheep. Lots of sheep. And doggy! Hey, buddy. Hi. I am really sorry about this. You are glitched. There we go. Sorry, Mr. German Shepherd. And sheep! And no, I'm not bothering to pick up the extra animals afterwards. There's, oh my god, this. I really wish you would stop doing that whole freezing thing. It's really kind of annoying. Stop freezing! Pick up all the bell peppers and all the eggplants and the chili peppers. I will say this about this particular area. If you're new to the game and you're trying to get established, Green Hills really is like your best place to go as your first area. There's like a huge number of places to be able to. I mean, if you want to be able to desecrate graves, you can do that and collect up cursed wood. There's a huge number of. Stop freezing! I swear this game is so acting stupid today. There's tons of things like this, tons of little items just here and there. It's sort of a loot central, and it's really good. Oh, look at this. Look at all the fertile soil. Let me tell ya, you want... Stop freezing! Oh, this game. Okay, so there's another way in there. Oh. Oh. Sorry, buddy. And that's a thing, too, is that you can also get DNA samples, which are... useful in the game. Why? Why can't I get into... Do I have to chop it down? Yes, I did. You know, I didn't even think about doing that in those other areas. I suppose I should have. Wool. Eggs. Tomatoes. Potatoes! Alright. But, I mean, for a first area to go to, for, like, after you get done with all the other stuff that you do, like, at land base and all that, you could definitely do a lot worse, as a beginning area than Green Hills. And I realize that I've kind of saved this for, like, almost last. But that was mainly just because I had, I had kind of gotten distracted with something else that I had wanted to do, at the time. And so really, that's my own fault. I sort of ended up gimping myself, to some extent. Hey, how did you manage... I tell you what, sheep. I kind of ended up kind of hurting myself a little bit by doing that. And I think in the next playthrough, if I have another playthrough of this, that I will most likely not do that. I will most likely finish up, like, I'll do Nova Base because that's the first area. And then probably come here. And then, like, maybe do land base. Or do I have that backwards? Is it land base, then Nova base? Or Nova base, and I don't know. But I won't be bouncing around like I did last time. Because I really did kind of gimp myself a little bit. By skipping this area. Yeah, I know there's more stuff. I'll just... I'm done for now. more marigolds, more dandelions. Always need, always need. And of course, there's stuff like this. that are all over the place that have stuff like this. I mean, if you can get a hold of a fire axe in the early game, these things are brilliant. And the crossbows early game, of course, you can find a crossbow in the very, very early game. But I don't think the crossbow is as powerful as this. Because this is a 30 damage, and as I recall, the crossbow in the first area, I believe it's less. You know what? I don't remember. It's been a long time since I first started this game, so it's been several hundred hours since I've played that. A lot of people don't realize, like, just how many hours I've put into this game. I've actually put an enormous number of hours into this game. Like several hundred. I mean, it's... I mean, I'm sure I could probably look... Where did it go? I could probably go and look and tell you for sure, but I know it's at least 200. And a lot of people are like, well, heck, Lion, that's nothing. I put in 1,000 hours every week. And it's like, okay, well, good for you. But for me, it's a lot, you know, 200's a lot of hours. You know, most of the time, I'm lucky to find enough time to be able to play in order to record, much less to have any fun on a game. which is kind of sad, because there are a lot of... Hello, sweetie. My sweetie has brought me some lemongrass tea. Awesome. But it can be really hard to find time even to record, much less find time for the other projects that I would really like to be doing. And I just realized I need to eat. And I need to drink. Did I? No, okay. And let's just eat twice. And drink a couple times. Maybe three. Yeah, let's just go ahead and drink three. There you go. Alright. Hello, Dawn. So, let's keep... Oh. And we do need to keep collecting these ingredients here. We do still have an enormous amount of taming and... What is... Oh, healthy sapling. Cool. Come back here. We need the flowers. Yep. A lot of people don't realize just how important elderberry flowers are. I mean, not just elderberries. Elderberry flowers. You need them. You gotta love them. If you don't love them, learn to love them. Oh, I probably didn't need that plant fiber, but that's all right. Oh, Dawn. Okay, so let's keep on looking in this direction. I'm sliding here, which is fine. We're gonna go. Okay, that's a stump. The fog is kind of blocking our vision a little bit, so we didn't get a chance to be able to see. Oh my gosh, how many shots do you guys need? I mean, I know you're like hellhounds, but yeesh. Of course, I'm used to, like, sniping these guys from a distance. I don't normally use the shotgun. I've actually been really tossing around the idea of maybe just now that I have my super sniper, and especially once I get the the anti-material rifle. Once I get the anti-material rifle, that's going to be the only weapon I use. Just period. The anti-material rifle is so absurdly powerful that, you know, once you have it, there really is no other reason to have any other weapon. And they're kind of a pain in the butt to make the ammo, and they're definitely hard to get all the materials for, because, I mean, you gotta find all of the, you gotta find all of the treasure badges, and boy, good luck trying to find all the treasure badges. You know, it just occurred to me, I wonder if the treasure, if there's a treasure badge in the ruins. Huh. You know, we may have to check that. We may just have to check that. Go ahead and grab this iron. I didn't mean titanium. I meant iron. And grab the quartz and silicon. Yeah. And grab these elderberries. There you go. And bust out the shotgun again. And we will continue to ride like the wind, Bullseye. Even though you're not Bullseye, you're Dawn. And I'm probably missing some things, but that's okay. What am I hearing? Did I not hear growling? You know what? I've got enough of this for now. I don't think I need to go get any more of those. I heard growling. Hear it?
Need to save room for ammo.
Oh. Ew. I did not realize I was full up. You know what? I do not... I'm just going to eat that rotten tomato. Or, I mean, rotten apple. Because why not? And gosh, you know what? I haven't had this problem in a long time. There's actually such a huge variety of things in this biome that I'm running out of room. Gosh, I haven't had this issue in a while. See, I'm hearing... That's not the horse. Oh, that's not the horse! Okay, get off, get off, get off. Okay. Oof. You're a biggin. He was a big one. Alright, so... Yeah, oh my gosh, I haven't had this problem in a while, where I've been collecting up so many so much stuff that's useful that I'm actually running out of space to hold it all. I mean, this is not a bad thing, like a bad problem to have, but it's just not one that I've had to deal with in a while. And I was silly and didn't bring my backup, my chest and backup thing, did I? Well, actually, can I just, I can't remember. Yes, I can. I can just build. I mean, I don't have enough nails on me, but I can just build a wooden box and just put it over by the spawn point and just load it up like I usually do. In fact, I'll probably do that before the end. Well, actually, probably at the end of the episode, I'll just head over there and I'll just... That way you guys aren't having to watch me do stuff like that. That's not fun. But I am seeing... what appears to have been a half-built pier hempweed. It looks like they were starting to build this pier, and I don't know if it just never got completed or what. I don't know what happened there. Grab that snakeweed. All right, and then I saw this over here. I think I'm gonna check this out. But before I do, napweed. I mean, if we're here, we may as well gather up the components. And we got more chickens. Hello, chickens. Oh. All right, grab. Got lots of chickies. Oh my. It's an herb garden. Holy cow, it's an herb garden. This place is amazing. Okay. I have to test this. Let's save the game here. Pick it up. Because... excuse me. If all of these things... will respawn. Oh. Oh, come on. I hate it when it does this. There we go. Oh, if it turns out that all of this will respawn, then... Oh. With the mushrooms. Oh my gosh, this is like... Why were people growing this here? Dude! Why are you growing this all of this here? You're amazing! Oh, and you know what? Go ahead and grab that here. All right. And let's... Oh, grab. Alright, this is the moment of truth here, even though it's very, very dark. Alright. And I know you can F5, F9. I know you can do that, but I'm so used to just doing it normally. If it respawns, then this is an amazing farm spot. Oh darn! I had a feeling it wasn't going to. Usually pre-planted stuff like this usually isn't. Hello? Come here. Usually pre-planted stuff like that isn't. And it would have been a lot... this would have been a broken farming spot. If in fact we could just, like, F5, F9 our way to victory there. So I'm kind of glad that it doesn't do that. Nice place for herbal seeds, though. But man, that would have been so good. That would have been so good. All right, let's throw down our sleeping bag here, and let's go to bed for the night. Because we're kind of running out of time in this episode. And I want to have some of my lemongrass tea. See, my sweetie... Whoa! My sweetie makes me a whole thermos of it. And I just kind of drink it throughout my recording, and it kind of keeps me clear, it keeps me hydrated, and lemongrass is good for losing the weight, because as some of you may or may not realize this, but I'm a tad overweight, and I really need to lose the weight, and so... she kind of looks out for me on that regard and kind of helps me to stay eating healthy. And I really appreciate that about her, because I am terrible about it. I just, timer is timing. All right, so let me go ahead and jump on my horse here. Strawberries too! Oh my gosh! Oh, this place, this farm is a gold mine. I don't know who. Hello, why can't? Oh, the hitboxes are real. That's just annoying. That is just annoying. And that's really too bad because this. Oh, wait a minute. Let's try this one. There we go. Because this little farm had, like, almost everything you needed to create a cure. And I'm kind of going, well, I mean, look, you had dog rose. And, in, like, all the different mushrooms and other things. This guy was, like, medicinal heaven. Dude, you're my hero. Who are you? I wish that like there was a name above your head or like a way to talk to you, because I would really like that ability to be able to just like go to these people and just say, you know, hi, what's your story? And, you know, you click on them and, you know, that comes up with a little option. Hi, what's your story? Hey, tell me about yourself. Hi, my name is Squeaking Lion, whatever. And they, you know, say, hi there, I am a humble farmer who likes cheese, you know, whatever. And I think it would be really cool if we could do that. And who knows, maybe that's going to happen someday. Maybe not. It just, I don't know. I don't know where the development for this is going. I'm not part of the development team. So maybe I'll find out as you guys find out. So I don't know. And in any case, guys, that's going to do it for this particular episode. Hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, do the liking and the subscribing and the commenting down below. You guys are just like, you just, you know. And I truly appreciate every single one of you. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, everyone, always remember that anyone can be a mouse that roars. That roars. I think I need some more lemongrass tea. But it takes someone special to be a lion that squeaks. So embrace your inner lion and squeak on! Oh yeah, this is definitely one of those recording sessions.